Thanks for telling me the questions I should ask. You will have your opportunity at the end
of my questioning. Just shut up and move on with your questions, okay?
Mr. Curry.
Just shut up or I'll adjourn this deposition and you can tell it to the judge or I'll get you some tissues and you can cry.
Mr. Curry.
All right?
Please don't tell me what to do.
You asked him if he ever spoke with Farsh about anything. He said no. Now you're asking him to tell you what Farsh told him. It is a bullshit question. It is absolutely speculative, no foundation or anything else. Now, he's entitled to a fair question. You told him that. So if you're going to sit there and ask unfair questions, I'm going to correct them. So I don't waste this guy's time having to come back or go to trial and undo the mess that you're trying to create. Got me?
Are you finished?
Are you finished?
Are you
aware Do you understand the question?
Are
Mr.
you
Chief?
Aware of the local rules with regard to what objections you're allowed to make and what
Do you
not?
Understand the question, Mr. Foster?
Sir, right now this is my witness. I get to ask the questions. You get to make objections only. There are two types of
Call
objections you can make. Objections
Call the form. Bailiff.
Sir.
Do you understand the question being asked, Mr. Foster?
Mr. Curry.
Don't ever presume that you get to tell me what to do or when to do it, counsel. Don't you ever presume. Mr. Foster, this is your deposition. Do you understand the question?
Why should you be entitled to then tell me what to do? Doesn't it go both ways?
Because I'm being straight with the guy, and you're being not straight with the guy. That's why. He has no dog in this fight.
Are you finished giving your opinions now about
He has no dog in this fight, and you're trying to get him to say things that are simply untrue. It's an old trick, Mr. Zohar.
You don't think you're
okay.
trying to coach the witness right now?
I'm telling him what the question is so he can answer it.
Do you know what speaking objections are?
Don't lecture me, idiot. I'm telling you I'm not gonna let that happen. Okay? You got me? Do
I
we understand each other?
Are understand
we,
the rules.
Are we connecting here? Because
I'm
if we're not connecting here, I will try again. Okay? Don't give me local rules, don't give me procedures, don't give me professionalism. Just put a fair question to the witness. And if you're not going to do that, then I am. We understand each other?
If you believe that a question that I ask is not proper, then you get to pose a valid objection. You're not allowed to make speaking objections. You're not allowed to give
Don't
your
lecture
opinions.
Me, puppy. Don't lecture me. I was doing this when you were still chasing cheerleaders. Don't you even think about lecturing me about depositions.
I think you're practicing a few years more than me, actually.
So,
that's it,
so,
to be honest with you.
Do you understand the question?
Mr. Curry?
Let's have the question right
It
back,
is my
please.
Desire to follow the rules. If you don't believe we should be following the rules, then maybe you need to explain to me what procedure we are supposed to follow.
Would you, now, do you think that there's anything wrong with adding test master students who you met only by virtue of your employment at test masters to a prospective client file for your competing company?
Would you read the question back, please?
Now, do you think that there's anything wrong with adding test master students who met only by virtue of your employment at test masters to a prospective client file for your competing company?
An object to the question is no foundation. It calls for speculation. It seeks a legal conclusion. It's argumentative, and I'm instructing the witness not to answer.
Mr. Tatey, do you think that it would be improper for you to copy your employer's course material while you're a test master's instructor and use it for a competing business?
Same objections, same instruction.
So as we sit here today, you don't know whether or not it's a true statement that as of March 30th, 2005, Blueprint had not yet finished the writing and production of its LSAT course.
Objection, argumentative, also invades the attorney-client privilege and the work product doctrine instructed not to answer.
Do you deny, Mr. Tatey, that as of January 12th of 2005, that Matt Riley was a Blueprint partner?
Objection. Same objections, same instruction.
Mr. Curry, this goes to the very heart of the case here, and I'd ask you to reconsider your instruction and allow Mr. Tatey to answer this very simple fundamental question.
I've reconsidered. The answer is no.
Can you rule out the possibility that Matthew Riley was a Blueprint partner while he was still teaching for test masters?
Same objection, same instruction.
Do you deny that Matthew Riley was a Blueprint partner at the same time that he was teaching Test Master's classes?
Same objection, same instruction.
Do you deny that Matt Riley was working on the Blueprint website while he was still teaching classes for Test Masters?
Objection. It's argumentative. Calls for speculation. There's no foundation. Struck the witness not to answer.
And can you say with certainty that Mr. McCarthy did not help in any way in helping Blueprint create the course material?
Objection. Calls for speculation. No foundation. It's argumentative. Struck the witness not to answer.
Do you deny that Courtney Martin was working for Blueprint on its website while she was a Test Master's instructor?
Objection. Same objection, same instruction.
Were you trying to get Courtney Martin to do work for Blueprint while she was a Test Master's employee?
Objection, vague and ambiguous. You can answer if you understand the question.
I don't believe that I was.
Do you deny that you were?
Objection. Ashton answered. Argumentative, no foundation, calls for speculation, struck the witness not to answer.
Now, why around this time period did you want to damage Robin Singh?
Objection. Calls for speculation, no foundation, it's argumentative, struck them not to answer, it's phrased. Okay, that's it.
Well, let me.
No, we're done.
Okay, that's fine. I'm not asking any more questions. I want to make a record here, if I may, Mr. Curry. I think that your instructions not to answer numerous questions are improper and unfortunate, particularly in light of these new documents that were just discovered. The judges repeatedly suggested that we should. There's a likelihood of having follow-on discovery after e-discovery. I think that it's improper, and I think that you're obstructing our ability to get to the bottom of these critical and highly damaging documents, and I'd like to put you on notice that if you don't allow us to continue to ask questions now or at a subsequent time, that we believe that you will be obstructing our ability to obtain evidence about improper discovery abuses by your client, and that you will be aiding and abetting in those discovery abuses. And I ask you to reconsider and permit us to ask Mr. Tatey these questions.
Take your threats and put them where you know better.
Well, I'm not making threats.
Yes, you are. Just tell it to the somebody who cares. See you Wednesday. Same step and my usual order.